Tonight in Fort Worth, there is an historical marker erected at a site acknowledging the racial lynching of a black man a century ago, 1921. New tonight, Caroline Vandergrift talked to the lynching victim's grandson about how he hopes that marker will help heal the community and start an open conversation about the past.
In an industrial area of Fort Worth, mostly unnoticed by passing cars, is the site of one of the darkest chapters in the city's history.
When I think about this happening in this community, in this space, it's just mind-blowing.
100 years ago, this is where Fred Rouse was lynched, a story so painful his own family couldn't bear to talk about it.
I was 46 when I found out. Yeah, so for 46 years, I never knew anything about this.
Fred Rouse was a black butcher for Swift & Company in the stockyards. As a strike breaker, he crossed both union and racial lines. Leaving work one day, he was attacked, stabbed, and left for dead by a group of strike agitators.
When police officers discovered Rouse was actually still alive, they brought him here to what used to be the City County Hospital. 5 days later, a mob of angry white men barged in and kidnapped him.
20 minutes later, he was hanging from a hackberry tree and his body was riddled with bullets. 100 years ago, just yesterday, blood soaked these grounds. And then for 100 years later to the day, to have his family, his blood relatives here, touching this ground again. So it's like everything came full circle. It's bittersweet.
His grandson, Fred Rouse III, is now working with the Tarrant County Coalition for Peace and Justice to bring awareness to what happened. They unveiled this historical marker on Saturday.
It was being hidden from everybody. And I think that with bringing this out, it really shows the true past of Fort Worth and all the things that happened.
The group also broke ground for the memorial they hope to eventually build on this site.
Transition taking place here today. We are groundbreaking to bring reconciliation, love, hope, and unity to the future of our Fort Worth.
Fred Rouse III says it's only by truly acknowledging the racism and violence that healing can begin.
A lot of people want to, you know, hide the bad and just only show the good. But I think this here, when you show the bad as well, you have a more complete community and you have a better community.
In Fort Worth, Caroline Vandergrift, CBS 11 News.